goes all out. A scene that should have been banned a long time ago. And Alex is surrounded by angry colleagues.
Where there's smoke, they pitch back.
Wahoo! Hello, it's Niall the Hero Boy. And I'm back once again. I had so many awesome adventures. It's been a while since me, Fangirl, DogTeamDog6, Nathan, and Tamatoa Gaming Da ranted on Collision Course, which is still an awful movie and one of the worst films I've ever seen. Today, we got another group rant. But this time, there will be more people than last time. And here they are right now. Introduce yourself, guys.
I love you, Sir Loves a Lot. Mwah.
Hello there, says Revenge of the Sith memes. Anyways, it's your favorite mashup pal and Rosalina lover, Dogs Eating Dog 6. That's me. Remember the name well. I'm finally back and about time too.
And before you say anything else, no, Rosalina will not be joining us today because she's already taking a break after casting Ice Age Collision Course into a supermassive black hole. So instead, she decided to let me continue to rant on another movie we really, really loathe. Ah, I bet she's in the Comet Observatory thinking about me and, wow, I am blushing right now. So anyways, who else is here besides us?
All right, Smashlight 21 entering stage left and I don't have any entourage with me. I've got a movie to talk about and what is it? Oh, it's a bad one. Well, time to become sophisticated. Oh, and also, thanks for letting me on the show.
Greetings, one and all. I am Tomatoa Gaming Dub back again in another rant video. Before we go any further, I want to say small things about modern SMO on whatever place plus stalls with puppets. It was because they got a cease and desist letter from Nintendo, as they were sued for messing up their characters. But still, it's there for a full flanderized Nintendo characters. If they hadn't flanderized Nintendo characters, then he wouldn't have got the cease and desist letter from Nintendo and used ugly puppets. Although, there was a movie that was recently uploaded by SMO. It was Jeffy's 18th birthday, and I need to tell y'all, at least modern SMO in that video approved a bit. That movie was actually decent. You guys need to watch it. But anyways, I brought some two people with me so that they can have fun with us in this rant. It's the girl of my dreams, of course, Mommy Tomoe, and Nagisa Momoe.
Hello, and I'm Mommy Tomoe, Tomatoa Gaming Does Love Interest. Nice to meet all of you, and I'm Nagisa Momoe. Hi, everyone!
Hello, everyone! It's me, Jason Gomez, the dinosaur. This is my first time being in the big rant. So, thanks for having me, guys.
Hello, I'm Nathan, and honestly, I just want to get this shit over with, so let's just move to the next person, please.
Hey guys, I'm ToxicX. You might recognize me from my videos, and this is going to be the first time ever doing a rant on Super Origami Kingdom. I'm very excited to be here with you all today.
Hello there, everyone. My name is PetronaStuff, and I'm here to rant on that awful movie, and I'm here to explain why it sucks with my friends here.
Hello to everyone out there on Super Origami Kingdom. I am JurassicVerse64. I would like to thank DogZeeAndDog6, aka Mashup Guy, and Rosalina Lover, Jason Gomez, and Niall for giving me this big opportunity to join Super Origami Kingdom. As you would know, I am a Let's Player, and I do voice dubs with all my good friends here, and I happen to have my own Dynamite Gar, like how Tamatoa Gaming Da and DD6 do, and her name is Lucina. She is from Fire Emblem Awakening. Come introduce yourself.
Hello, I am Lucina, Princess of Elise, and Jurassic Verse 64's love interest. Pleasure meeting you all.
Now that everyone has introduced themselves, let's talk about the topic of today's video. Honestly, believe it or not when I say that this is a movie, no, wait, no, a commercial, that I find even worse than Norm of the Nord. What is it, you may ask? Well, here's your answer. Fucking surfs up to WaveMania!
This commercial is really nothing more than an advertisement for WWE.
This goes to show how low WWE has fallen.
This wasn't the first time WWE was involved in a commercial starring great movies or shows. They did this in the Flintstones, the Jetsons, and even Scooby-Doo.
But unfortunately, they weren't done there.
Nope. They thought it was a good idea to make a half-assed feature-length commercial that just so happens to feature the characters in Surf's Up.
And look at how that turned out. We got one of the worst productions ever seen by mankind.
They decided to fuck up, well,
everything! Surf's Up 2 is by far the worst commercial ever!
The characters in comedy are all absolutely awful!
Before I truly go all out, I want to start off by saying that Surf's Up is amazing. It's one of the most unique and underrated films I have ever seen. I highly recommend seeing it. Trust me, you will love it like I did. If only this fucking commercial went to hell!
I really enjoyed Surf's Up when I was young. I even loved it more than the other Penguin movie, Happy Feet. But now this had to exist! It ruined everything from my childhood! Surf's Up 2 remade it, took the childhood away from me!
Before we begin, I just want to say, if Schaefer's Productions never made a Sony Animation movie ranking, we would have forgotten that this commercial even exists. So, subscribe to him when you get the chance.
And if it weren't for HBO Max having this movie, I would never have had this opportunity to join the rant!
Wait, is it still there? Considering the train wreck that HBO Max has become. But that's a story for another time.
And one more thing, even if this is a rant, me and Bebe won't be cursing during this rant. Everyone else, except the two of us. I really swear, but for this case, it's my deep hatred for this film. No, wait, commercial. For a tiny bit.
Also, normally I don't swear a lot like what happened during the other rants, but here, oh boy, I am going all out. I will really swear this time, so if you don't like it, I suggest not watching the video. But if you do, get yourself some popcorn and enjoy watching me go all out this time. A lot more. With all that said, it's time. It's time to rip this commercial to shreds and burn it to the fucking ground. Here is why Surf's Up 2 is soul-sucking awfulness.
I'll use more British expressions, but no obscene language here.
Anyways, let us begin.
Let me just say, Surf's Up is one of those films that never needed a fucking sequel.
Really? We literally just started the review, and yet, someone's already yelling.
And it is justified. This movie, no commercial, is fucking atrocious.
In fact, this commercial is so fucking terrible that I'm looking back fondly to Batman and Robin. That's right, a movie that is so bad that it's good is more enjoyable than this travesty. Now, let's talk about what made Surf's Up amazing in the first place.
Surf's Up is one of the most unique animated movies out there. That movie is more like a documentary with the characters interacting with the cameraman and the shaky camera. Then there's this commercial, which basically takes all that away to make it more like a reality TV show, which doesn't even feel like they're part of the freaking commercial.
For me, I would like to count down this character, Undertaker, but I'll tell you all about him later.
It's the same thing I said. I love Surf's Up, but Surf's Up 2 made me cry for ruining my childhood.
This fucking product is also the most insulting thing I have ever seen in my entire life. I love Surf's Up so much, but this awful commercial ruined everything from the first one.
The first movie is all about Cody idolizing Big Z, and him eventually learning that winning isn't that all important. But WWE basically said, fuck Big Z, and replace him with the Hang Five, and have Cody idolize the John Cena Penguin instead! Fuck!
Not to mention, Cody is an absolute dickhead who cares about nothing other than winning! This is the perfect example of character assassination!
This isn't even a Cody Merrifield I know from the first movie anymore. What has he turned into? He has turned into someone else! He's like Chick Hicks in the first Cars movie! Speaking of Chick Hicks, he's such an annoying villain! Professor Zemdia from Cars 2 is a much better villain! The plot is pretty much the same thing as the first movie!
I guess we'll start talking about the plot of this shitty commercial.
So we start off with a recap of Surf's Up, specifically when Cody sacrificed his chance of winning to save Chicken Joe, where he learns a valuable lesson that winning isn't everything.
Such a heroic life for a protagonist. How inspiring indeed. And Cody happily accepted his loss and Surf's Up decided to surf for fun with Big Z.
After that, they basically said, fuck the first movie, and not only did they get rid of Big Z and replace it with a John Cena Penguin, they also turned Cody into a fucking prick who is obsessed with winning!
What the fuck?
Then we get a surfing scene and fucking hell, look at the animation. It is so awful compared to the first movie.
I mean, it was at a lower budget, so of course the animation would be downgraded. Because why put a high budget in a WWE commercial?
Also, the animation looks less appealing and it looks more like a cartoon show. Look at the budget, Sirso. It went with a bigger budget and looks way more realistic and detailed and looked on the characters and background.
The animation in general is such a complete eyesore. This looks like it should belong in a TV show.
This was direct to DVD. The first one was a full theatrical release, so that it was obvious a downgrade was to happen. May I make a comparison? This is Surf's Up 2, and here, this is still from Beast Wars, a TV show from 1996. Which looks better? And there is a correct answer. It's the one where some T-Rex says, yes.
Cody's been interviewed, which results in advertisement for his own surfing school, which, by the way, is dragged out and is not funny!
This commercial has already started, and I'm already filled with dread!
An advert within an advert. Funny? Not. Think Hamlet by Shakespeare, and now that has and play within a play. But worse.
Not funny! Didn't laugh!
So, Chicken Joe gives Cody a Hang 5 poster, and as a result, we get a flashback. I guess they're trying to say Big Z never existed because now Cody idolizes the fucking John Cena Penguin and his legion of super friends! And look at the designs of the Hang 5! These penguins are on steroids!
Those penguins I'm seeing right there are so ugly. Oh, this makes me mad because I don't ever want to watch that movie because Surf's Up 2 is so disgraceful, disgusting, and despicable. Like what Gordon, James, and Henry said, I just wish it was cancelled.
Those character designs are totally fucking awful. Don't worry. We will talk more about that later.
Back to the present, the Hang 5 just appear out of nowhere, and
I like milk and fish, because I'm an otter, and otters like fish. I just wish you could milk a fish.
Oh my god, it makes me sick. Oh my, I feel like I might throw up. Oh no, here it comes.
Oh my god!
Okay, everyone, we are back, and we feel much better. Wait, hey guys, where were we?
Don't even get me started on this thing, because this thing right here still haunts my dreams.
How fucking dare you make such a sausage party reference in a kids movie! You've truly disgusted me and my friends. What's worse, you put the Holy Quentin in danger from watching that shithole. There are girls, and girls are disgusted to see that shit.
And consider yourself lucky that baby didn't watch this. You know what happens to her when she accidentally watched the ultimate punishment scene of King Ollie's show episode 3? Not even Madoka and the others would watch this.
Cause if they did, then one day you'll have to answer for your actions. And God may not be so merciful.
Just you! Is that seal really an idiot? Why will he do that on the fish? Oh, it makes me sick. I feel like I might throw up.
This scene is somewhat disturbing. Unlike my colleagues here, I don't actually care for this. It's a literal 2 or so second gag for the adults. Kids, you don't get it. So, what's the problem? I don't see it. And you are all overreacting.
I'm mentally scarred right now because of this atrocity. I'll never look at fish or otters the same way ever again!
Fucking hell, Sosa 2! Why would you show this in a kids movie? For fucking ass Christ's sake! Now my girl is serious, standing there. I see as a great peril because you dickheads put such an inappropriate scene in there. For what? Just to make us laugh? Fucking hell no! There are people who are way too sensitive to see this shit. Do you know how many people were disturbed by the scene? I'm sure you don't, because you seem to be a great company of some fans or artists who put on a circuit from a fish's ass. I wish you would.
On that scene! Is it like the scene of Sausage Party? But oh my god! That is so disgusting! Oh, I feel like I want to destroy that scene! Sausage 2 should have made a deleted scene! Because that is so it's disgusting! And also, don't let your kids see that!
What? There's a fish milking scene? Oh my god. Why will Surf's Up 2 have that scene? It is so disgusting. I will be angry, more angry than you guys will ever see. And I agree with Dark Bowser Jr. Surf's Up 2 should have made that as a deleted scene. But looks like they don't care at all.
And you know what else? This looks like one of those shitty cowboy gags from Modern Family Guy! This scene can be summed up in 3 simple words!
Disgraceful, said Gordon. Disgusting, said James. Despicable, said Henry. We cannot allow it.
Honestly, that fish milking scene is worse than everything in Sausage Party. Who the fuck thought that this was a good idea to do this? This makes me want to throw up so badly!
And just like with Bowsette's Cody Space Transplant, Peter Griffin's disfigured face, and President Koopa, and like what Kyoko Sakura and Balletta said, this scene should also be deleted!
Surf's Up 2 may be worse like Sausage Party, because that scene is the worst like Sausage Party. I don't like Sausage Party.
And finally, here's what I think of that god-awful scene before we go much further.
I just wish you could milk a fish.
Anyway, we all had dinner on the island, and Mick Maron says he's retiring after he served at the trenches.
But suddenly, the Undertaker comes out of nowhere and almost eats Chicken Joe, and then asks Chicken Joe if he can lay an egg in his mouth? What the fuck? Why?
Okay then, here's the worst thing I just noticed. Undertaker almost ate Chicken Joe? I'm pretty sure he's an idiot, because he almost ate him. You cannot eat a live chicken like that. That Undertaker's like an idiot!
It's a shame, because in actual WWE, The Undertaker was always this menacing force who symbolizes the Green Reaper. And in this, he's a bit thick.
I'm thick!
He also has a talking conch for some reason, which by the way is never fucking explained to the audience!
We then get it to an unfunny moment where they are on a whale, and then the fucking annoying seagull comes out of nowhere.
Forward, ever forward, our intrepid team presses on, woefully unaware that no penguin has ever ventured into the trenches and lived to tell the story.
Nobody cares!
Now they are in a desert where we get this surfing scene and John Cena showing off how strong he is. I swear all this budget just went into John Cena's muscles. Not interesting at all, just cringe all around. Fucking hell!
Correction. It did.
And the quicksand scene, you would only sink to your waist because the quicksand has a density about 2 grams per millimeter. This isn't like Mario 64 or other movies where you'll sink all the way to the bottom. And what's this? The Undertaker wants to live in the desert now?
Are you serious? Undertaker feels like he wants to live here around the sinking sand? Come on! The sinking sand... it's like quicksand, and you feel like living there? Okay, I'm pretty sure Undertaker is really an idiot. Oh good, now you're starting to sink in the quicksand, and you feel like living there now? Ha! How pathetic. I hope you die. But wait a minute, you got free now. Wow, amazing.
Undertaker wants to live in a desert like that, where there's quicksand everywhere? Oh, he's really an idiot. Why would you live on the desert where there's quicksand everywhere? And you feel like living there? But now you're starting to sink on the quicksand, and you feel like living there now? Okay, I'm pretty sure Undertaker's an idiot.
Tank sabotages Cody because he's a prick, but honestly, Cody deserves it, because he's an even bigger prick.
After a shit ton of filler, everyone is playing on a high tightrope. As a result, they fall off a cliff and somehow survive! What the fuck?
To be fair, it is fiction. Anything's possible, but I still agree. And I've seen a movie where a talking cockapoo does a kamikaze but ejects just as the crash is about to happen. At least this guy there seems to have lightning fast reaction times. It still makes sense, he's trained for that, but here? But again, that's for another day. No. Physics should determine the swing at such a rate they'd hit the ground and most likely die.
True, surfing penguins was never realistic in the first place.
But the fact that they survived landing on concrete without any breaking their fall, it's fucking ridiculous!
People could die or get hurt from falling a high place. You could get a serious fracture, broken bones, and other major injuries.
Yeah, just like what Dog Zine Dog 6, Tamatoa, Mammy, and Lucina said, It looks more like a fucking video game!
Okay, here is another scene on that tightrope. Undertaker just slide on his back! That would be so dangerous! How will people slide on their backs on a tightrope? Maybe tightropes are probably hard, but if you slide one, you'll get a scratch on your back. That will be heard as more.
The enemies get split up and end up in different places in a temple.
Then Tate made the idiot he steals the golden surf form, which causes all temple to get destroyed.
But look at this! Tank gets away with it scot-free, cause why the fuck not?
So mad now they just want to scream his face furiously!
Cody starts a fight with Tank, cause he's a fucking prick, which leads to the wrestlers doing their own signature moves, and, well, you guessed it, Cody got his ass kicked.
And Cody fucking deserves it, because he is a big dick! Don't worry, we'll talk more about the asshole later.
Clips like that, you know that you're gonna have a bad time. And as if the fish milking scene and Koji being insufferable weren't enough, guess what? Things go downhill yet again!
Now they have to glide over lava and... Was there something in my last cup of tea?
Koji literally goes out of his way to sabotage Tank in a very dangerous setting, which nearly gets Chicken Joe killed. What the fuck? No, actually, what the actual fuck? This is the prime example of character assassination. If Tank was the one to kill Cody, that would have been much more believable. How fucking dare you, Cody? How fucking dare you?
Even after the Hang 5 calls him out for this, Cody just justifies his shitty actions. What a fucking asshole. No wonder Cody is such a clusterfuck, but while Tank was the main antagonist in the original Surf's Up movie, Cody and Tank switch places in Surf's Up 2 for Cody to be the main antagonist in that Jesus fucking Christ commercial!
Cody has truly disappointed me, including the Holy Quintet, but most importantly, Bebe! Yeah, I thought Cody was a good person, but he's not! Cody used to be so likable, but now, he's become more of an asshole of a character! This is a prime example of terrible character finalization!
While Cody is on his own, the others make it to the trenches, which, by the way, looks exactly like the boneyards from the first movie.
We then see this annoying seagull again, and then this happens.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for!
Ha ha ha! Laugh, Percy. Good riddance, fuckface!
Fuck yes, the annoying seagull is dead. Ugh, if only everything in this commercial would be killed. That way, this commercial would never happen.
Lonnie and Chicken Joe decline to surf in the trenches while Tang goes, but immediately has second thoughts. As a result,
the Hang 5 push Tank away, almost killing him! Even after they lecture told him about working as a team! Fucking hypocrites!
Undertaker is struck by lightning, so the rest of the Hang 5 have to ditch their boards. Cody arrives at the scene to save Tank, and John Cena saves them both.
Mainly because they just can't give any of the wrestlers negative traits. Every wrestler in this commercial has to be fucking perfect!
Chicken Joe reminds the Undertaker, what the heck is this? Why is he wearing the jellyfish as a surprise?
Because of poorly written comedy. Seriously, there's nothing funny about this scene, but is it really worth making a fuss over?
Yes!
Okay then.
The things I do for this job.
Oh my gosh, I turn into Fury Anger Form because you might want to see what happened to Undertaker when he can finally breathe. Look at that! Chicken Joe forgot to get the jellyfishes off of Undertaker! Oh my god! And he had those weird jellyfishes on him. They gotta remind you of the word, Ike. Yeah, that's the word, but oh my god! That is the worst scene ever! Just what the heck? Why would wooden chicken Joe take on the jellyfishes of Undertaker! Now Undertaker looks like a girl! And he has a bra of jellyfishes! I hate that scene! I don't ever want to watch Surf's Up 2 ever again!
Anyways, Cody gets offered a spot on the Hang 5, but he declines because generic protagonist reasons. But it turns out that Mr. McMahon isn't retiring, ultimately making everything in this commercial fucking useless! And Cody makes another advertisement for his shitty surf school. The end. Finally, it's fucking over.
Sadly, we are not done just yet. We still have to talk about the characters, which, by the way, there are very few in this WWE advertisement.
Tank and Chicken Joe actually remained the same for the most part, so I guess they can be spared. But as for the rest, fuck no.
These characters are so fucking awful. They are a billion times worse than all the characters in Norm of the North. These characters make me feel...
so fucking angry! They insult me! They are never getting off scot-free! Anyways, let's begin talking about these fucking god-awful piece of shit characters!
Starting with John Cena as himself. He is literally where all the budget went into! The visuals in this commercial are absolute shit! But all they focus on are his penguin muscles!
Oh, and not to mention that the one of his legion of super shits was Big Z! Big Z is one of, if not the most important character!
Undertaker, the voice of THE Undertaker.
Wait a minute, this can't be right.
Undertaker was voiced by THE Undertaker? What the heck? Is that like a real name or something? So Undertaker was voiced by THE Undertaker? Okay, that's making me confused.
Taker Penguin is a complete idiot!
There are constant jokes about him liking death, which just drag on and on. We fucking get it!
There's three reasons about Undertaker. Like, first, almost a Chicken Joe. Feels like living on the desert where there's quicksand everywhere. And has a bra of jellyfishes. That will be a bad character for Undertaker. I will be very angry. Very, very, very angry if I will kill Undertaker. Because he is the worst character ever. And I agree with Jason.
Undertaker is the worst character ever in Surf's Up 2. Well, here's the first problem that I notice about Undertaker. Undertaker almost ate Chicken Joe. But you can't eat a live chicken! Have you all ever seen a live chicken when people ate it? No! No one eats a live chicken! They only eat cooked chicken! So why would Undertaker almost eat Chicken Joe? That would be this.
The McMahon honor mentally scars me and the rest of my friends on Discord, namely that fish milking scene. Why? That shit is fucking disgusting! I can't stop thinking about that fucking scene and asking myself, why the fuck does this exist? Who asked for this?
Nobody fucking said yes! It makes us all feel like throwing up!
It exists as a gag, so the adults watching can have a laugh. Most kids' movies these days do have some adult humour, and the film is rated PG by the BBFC, the British Board of Film Classification for those who are not from Britain. So basically, almost everyone here, and most viewers, for mild bad language, really? Violence? Well, it is WWE after all, and threat. Nothing on rude humour. Odd.
And to quote the angry video game nerd, what were they thinking?
Get the thing out of my face and my timeline!
I like milk.
And fish.
Cause I'm a
pillock. Pillock.
Just like cringe. I just wish you could milk a fish.
Hunter, Triple H, and Paige are just pathetically bland and boring characters. I guess the same could be said about the rest of the Hang 5. All they have are positive traits because, God forbid, they make the wrestlers look bad in a WWE commercial. Money, that's why. Vince was footing the bill and they had to make it to their standards, which were obviously quite low.
Melissa Sturm as Lanny serves absolutely no purpose in this commercial. Moving on.
And now we save the best to last, as we love to call it the worst to last of this commercial. And believe us, Tomatoa will turn his fury for again just like he did during his modern SML rant. He also ranted on the live-action Mario movie, too.
Now, without further ado, the worst to last in the WWE advertisement is...
Jeremy Snyder as Tony Maverick!
First off, they replaced Shia LaBeouf. Yes, it was him originally. Guess he was too expensive to bring back? Considering the first one came out in 2006 before Shia hit the big time with the 2.5-hour car advertisement that was Michael Bay's Transformers. Then again, that still has a plot, despite being an advertisement for the then upcoming new Chevrolet Camaro. But Sony do seem to like changing lead voices. Take Open Season, where they had Martin Lawrence of Bad Boys fame, and Ashton Kutcher, the former holder of the most followers on Twitter, but the sequels kept changing around them. But aside from that, he's a twat.
I have not seen a better example of character assassination. And believe me, I've seen plenty of examples. Just like Luke in The Last Jedi, for one.
Cody literally went out of his own way to try to kill Tag! Jesus Christ! Isn't he supposed to be the protagonist?
Even though that Cody did a bad accident for Chicken Joe's surfboard, that would have been an accident, would it?
No!
He has an obsession over winning, and even though in the first movie he learned that winning isn't everything, what the fuck happened here? Everything about him is fucking ruined!
He is selfish, annoying, and overall just a fucking asshole!
Not to mention like how whiny he is, like what the hell? The main issue is something called flanderization. Cody basically prints everything he's learned from Big Zed in Movie 1 to being a glory seeker whose only goal is to impress the WWE people to take Vince McMahon's place. Ironically, the fact that Vince McMahon has actually finally retired due to issues kind of shows the whole thing was maybe ahead of the time? Maybe?
Cut it out, Tank! We're trying to film a commercial here, man!
Stop your foul whining, you filthy piece of distended rectum!
I'll say this yet. I'll say it again. No wonder Cody is such a clusterfuck. That's why Tank was the main antagonist in the original Suicide movie. Cody and Tank switched places in System 2 for Cody to be the main antagonist in a Jesus fucking Christ commercial.
He truly is, as Flowey would put it, an idiot!
This guy can go burn in the deepest depths of hell for all I care.
Congratulations, Norm! You're no longer my most hated protagonist! It's now Cody from Surf's Up 2! Norm is super annoying, sure, but Cody from Surf's Up 2 is an annoying dick! I fucking despise him! I loved him in the first one, but here? Fuck no!
His behavior also reminds me of Robin and Jasper Bat Jr.
As atrocious as Jasper Bat Jr. was, At least he had some good music during his boss fight. And as atrocious as Robin was, at least he wasn't like his Teen Titans Go counterpart. But Cody in this atrocity, there is absolutely no excuse behind this, like, at all.
His behavior reminds me of Massey Lava for Jurassic World Dominion. And don't even get me started with her. She was a brat and a bitch in that movie. At least she was okay in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom.
I want to fucking tear him apart piece by piece until there is nothing left.
Will you lot reel it in and calm yourselves? I thought we were making a professional review here.
Hey guys, SpongeBob here, and today I'm going to say why I hate this movie. The first thing I hate about the movie is the infamous fish scene where Vince the Otter said,
"Hey, I have an idea. I like milk and fish because I'm an otter, and otters like fish. I just wish you could milk a fish."
And then it shows a thought bubble with Vince drinking milk out of the butt of a fish. That moment disgusted me, and I wish I never even watched this crap. The second most horrifying thing about this movie was the fact that The Undertaker wanted to use jellyfish as a fucking bra. What the hell? That's stupid. Why would you do that? I don't understand why you thought it was a good idea to do such a thing like that. I don't understand why you think putting jellyfish on your boobs would be good, since if I were to do that, the jellyfish would be awfully stingy on my chest. Screw this movie. I hate it, I loathe it, and I never wanna see it in my life. What's worse is that they didn't even bring back Big Z from the first movie, which was a masterpiece, by the way. I don't understand why Big Z, one of the most important characters, wasn't brought back. And what's worse, The Undertaker wanted to live in quicksand! Quicksand kills people! What is wrong with you? Do you honestly think that this would be good? No, hell no! Screw this movie! I don't understand why they thought it was a good idea.
This commercial is not only the worst Sony product I've seen, it is also by far the worst commercial in existence.
There are so many sequels out there, believe me, like some other Sony movies.
Or even watch Happy Feet 2. At least that penguin movie didn't have as many false actions unlike this childhood destroyer.
There is like an equality, which is, wait a minute, there isn't one. That's right, this commercial is that fucking awful.
Fun fact.
I would rather sit through the finale of Game of Thrones than ever suffer through watching this pile of shit again. Seriously, I bet the writers of that would say, well, at least we didn't fuck up that badly.
And I would rather watch Batman and Robin again than sit through some commercial ever again. And again, at least it is considered more of a movie. A movie so bad that it's good. But this, it's just so bad that it's atrocious.
This commercial is straight up awful. The jokes are unfunny, it takes away from the good source material from the first movie, and it's just overall a cinematic disaster. As expected from a feature-length WWE commercial that was released in 2016, straight to DVD. Just watch Scooby-Doo WrestleMania Mystery, because that actually has a plot that works. All this makes you want the Attitude Era back. The good days of playing SmackDown Shut Your Mouth on PlayStation 2 as The Rock against Stone Cold Steve Austin. They wouldn't have this. No offense, people, but was this truly the worst thing ever? I could see 100% for you guys, even though I do hate it, there are so many much worse films out there. Okay, basically makes the retcons everything from one and makes the protag a dick, and the WWE stuff exists. 0.25 out of 10.
They literally just took the plot from its greatest predecessor and just decided to take away everything good, or at least decent, thus making this monstrosity of a movie, if I could even call it a movie.
The biggest crime this commercial has committed was removing Big Z. Again, he was basically the most important character in the first movie, which, by the way, is at least 1,000 times better than this piece of shit that is this WWE commercial.
Big Z was Cody's inspiration, and he had the goddamn guts to take on the commercial. I'll never forgive the writers for ruining and replacing him with that John Cena penguin. They made the WWE wrestlers perfect in every swing, which makes them boring and unlikable.
But hey, it's not a fucking Cody's character, cause why not?
This feature-length commercial gets a 0 out of 10. Hell, maybe even less than that. How about a negative 1 million out of 10? Yes, that's right. I fucking love this commercial so fucking much. Worst thing I have ever seen in my entire fucking life. It makes Northern North look like Revenge of the Sith. It makes Ice Age Collision Course look like the first Ice Age movie. And it makes the Emoji Movie look like the Lego Movie. Fuck this commercial big time. Go to hell, Surf's Up 2. I don't ever want to see you again in my entire fucking life.
I believe this commercial deserves to be rated an infinite amount of negatives.
Fuck this movie. No. Fuck this fucking ass last commercial.
This is what we will say. Screw Surf's Up 2 Mania. The worst commercial that we ever seen in our whole entire life. You know what? I agree. Like what Dark Bowser Jr. said, they should make a deleted scene of that fish milking scene, because that is so gross.
Before the main punishment, we will do something similar to episode 3 of the King Ollie Show, which will be a punishment day.
Oh hell yes, this will get as many punishments indeed. Since this product is that fucking awful, it will get zero mercy.
Punishments? Really? You're on your own on that one. I can't stop you, so have fun. My work here is done. And these are now my colleagues.
Let's get those sons of glitches!
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you all have been waiting for. Today is Punishment Day. The previous Punishment Day has worked so well before as we have no problem doing it again. So, here we go again. First punishment, destroying the commercial while going berserk.
We hate that! We hate it all! That's it! I hate that commercial so darn much! Because I hate Undertaker so much! All of it in general! And did you watch the live in a desert? And has a bro that looks like a girl with jellyfishes! Screw it! I'm a fire in the navel!
Second punishment, Mommy Domoey fighting the commercial.
Sorry for the interruption, but this won't take long! Gotcha!
Third punishment, the indoor raptor eating the Hang 5, ripping them to shreds.
Ah!
Fourth punishment, Charlotte eating the commercial. Fifth punishment, Madoka Kaname using all of her power against the commercial itself. Sixth punishment, Alina Gray angry at the commercial as she terrorizes the commercial. Seventh punishment, Dio Brando using his road roller on it.
7 seconds. I'm going to roll all over you! Time to die! I did it.
Eighth punishment, Tyrannosaur Buck and Tyrannosaur Dome from the Lost World ripping Mr. McMahon in half. Ninth punishment, Lucina destroying the characters with her final smash.
I cannot lose. Come at me. Time to change
it! Tenth punishment, Jotaro Kajo using Star Platinum for the Aura Barrage.
Good grief. I know this is blatantly obvious, but you really are a piece of work. What you owe me.
You can never be paid back with money!
You can keep the freaking change.
Eleventh punishment, the commercial facing my fury, warning, ear rape.
You have officially messed with the bull.
And now, here comes the horns.
Final punishment before moving on to the main punishment, Professor Zundap, Acer, Graham, also some other lemons, use the camera at max power to kill Surfs up to like the scene where they did that to Rod.
The project is still on schedule. You will find the second agent and kill him.
Now, we finally reached the ultimate punishment for featuring the biggest example of character flanderization I have ever fucking seen, making a scene that we can't unsee, and taking away from good source material in the first Surf's Up movie. I hereby sentence Surf's Up 2 Wave Fucking Mania to be destroyed by me and my entire team. Now first, I will need to call them to arrive. I will be back after that.
Eventually.
I'm glad you're all here.
Okay, this better be important. What is Gotham, Nairo? Also, it is a good thing that you and I are not enemies at this moment.
Oh, it is. I want you all to do something. You know that commercial Surf's Up 2, WaveMania?
Yes! I remember that commercial! I want it to sweep eternally in the Dark Power's embrace!
Good, because that's what I want you to do. In fact, I want you all to destroy it.
Oh my god, you know what? I agree with you, Niall. I hit this more than Nomura North. Also, that specific scene with the fish-looking part is worse than everything in Sausage Party!
Oh my god! I've invoked this atrocity to be sent to my nightmare! But unlike when I sent you, Niall, to my nightmare back when you and I fought, you escaped, but Surf's Up 2 did not escape at all!
Once again, I shall cut a worthless object, but this time, it's not only worthless, no, it's also an insulting object!
This is the worst thing ever! And I thought Batman and Robin was the worst film ever! But this commercial makes it look like the Batman, the Dark Knight, and the Lego Batman movie!
Alright, everyone on my team, let's destroy it together!
I just wish you could milk a fish.
Fight! Fight!
JC
Jr. In a crime?
And his name is John C.
No. He despised you. You were an embarrassment to him.
You want forgiveness?
Get religion.
See you, chump.
Fight!
More exciting content on Super Origami Kingdom.
Of course. Also, I plan on defending Cars 2 since it gets too much hate. And I mean way too much hate. But I will defend it for sure. Don't worry, Cars 2, you will get some defense. Just pick on Brave and the Good Dinosaur. I don't hate them, but they are boring, dull, and very disappointing. Cars 2 deserves much more love.
That's a topic for another video.
Say, baby, wanna come over to my apartment and have cheese? Yeah, we'll see y'all next time. Bye, everyone.
I'll meet you two there. Anyways, our next video here on Super Origami Kingdom will be the Mario mainline characters good to evil. Also, stay tuned for Act 6 of Origami Kingdom Musical and The King Ollie Show Episode 4 featuring Mario and Bowser.
One last thing, we do not recommend Surf's Up 2 WaveMania. Instead, just watch the first movie and pretend this commercial never existed. Also coming soon, I will be doing a rant on Jurassic World Dominion! So keep an eye out for that. Once again, thank you Jason, Niall, and DED6 for inviting me to the rant. Me and Lucina are now going to spend time together in Biosyn Sanctuary. So like and subscribe to Super Origami Kingdom. And subscribe to all my friends here.
I hope you all look forward to that. And I'll be helping Jurassic Verse 64 on the rant with him. Together, we'll tackle everything that is wrong with this film.
Also, before I go, the next video on my channel will be In the Final, starring Dogs Eat Dog 6 as Dark Bowser, me as Bowser, obviously, Niall as Mario, and Jason as Fawful. I don't know who will be Luigi, but I'll find someone. Anyways, see y'all next time.
And the fact that Rosalina also hated the literal WWE commercial, which is why she told me to never watch it again. Anyways, I shall return back to the Comet Observatory and spend more time with my dear, sweet, beautiful Rosalina.
Actually, one last thing. The next video on my channel will be the one you've been waiting for, Adventures End V2. So, hope you look forward to that one.
Remember, where there's smoke, they pinch back. Ciao!
Oh!
If you hit the dial on channel 3, you get my views on the Paw Patrol movie, which was good. Or you could switch over to channel 2 and watch the entire Origami Kingdom musical. Or you could watch the entire video about game box art. Oh, whatever. This has been Smash Alex 21 for Super Origami Kingdom. Over and out.
Also, everyone, go ahead and check out the short rant about Surf's Up 2 on my channel.
Thank you all very much for watching this video. I have never been more mad than now. Anyways, see you next time on Super Origami Kingdom. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must go spend more time with the rest of my team. Ciao!
Is not a feature-length commercial. It is a movie. Oh, shish. Cody in this is an annoying
penis
who's overly obsessed with
Yay, Luigi.
Oh, yeah.
He was inspired by Penguin Josh Cease and his legion of super friends. None! So they rightfully tell him to
turn into a Goomba!
It's been one of those days.
Disappointment in the game of life.